I'm a pharmacist, and I will tell you that in most cases, I'm fine for myself or anybody else advising them to go ahead and get the generics. However, in this particular case, it wasn't the $1,000 copays that I was going to have to do now instead of the insurance company and getting to save the money. And there's something else which I'll alert you to shortly. But the company that was making the generic is called, Camphor Pharmaceuticals, which is a parent company of Hetero Pharmaceuticals of Hyderabad, India. That particular generic company had been lambasted by the FDA for quality reasons, for cleanliness reasons, for substandard product reasons. They actually had them on videotape destroying their quality control documents in the middle of the night. So it's not just that, okay, bite the bullet, I got to pick up the $1,000 copays. It's a substandard product. I've been stabilized. I've been on this drug for 6 years, and my physician agreed we should not change you to this other product because that's not a real good thing. So they went through and filed the prior authorization requests. That was on January 19th. On January 22nd, I got my refill for a 90-day supply. So I think everything's great. But then a few months later, I started running out of the medication and I wasn't getting my usual reminder refill from the pharmacy. They didn't call me and say, hey, Gina, you probably should have a refill of your prescription. Why don't you order it? They didn't call me. So I thought, I better call my pharmacy, Walgreens Specialty Prime. When I called, they said, oh, you know what? You need another prior authorization. I said, we just did that. And we did that in January. Why do I need another one? Well, we can't fill it because your insurance company won't pay for it. You're going to have to get another one. So I'm on the phone.
Shield.
What's that?
Blue Shield.
Yeah, this is a federal Blue Cross Blue Shield of Michigan. So I called the doctor and said, you know, I'm sorry to bother you, but my insurance company is asking to have you fill out more paperwork and file another prior authorization. So if you could do that, well, you know, I leave that with them. A week goes by. I hear nothing from no one. Starting to run out of the drug. I call again. The insurance says, nope, won't go through. Doctor says I filed the request. I got nothing. I let another week go by. Pretty soon, I'm out of the drug. Okay. So they actually allowed me to run out of the drug without rectifying this. And now I want to show you what the real problem is. There's an intermediary. When you, I got a couple of visuals for you here that hopefully people can see. But this one right here, this is how patients perceive the RX process. And if you're uninsured, this is pretty much how it works. Your doctor writes a prescription, they send it to the pharmacy, and you get to go pick it up. Okay? That's how you think that your prescription process works. Now I want to show you how it really works when you have insurance. It's a bit more complicated than that. Okay. Your doctor writes a prescription and there's middleman.
This looks like what the FBI uses when they're trying to prosecute a RICO act against mobsters. That's what they have on the board. And this is a racket. These are racketeers.
I want to show you how much of a racket this really is. You see this thing in the middle I have in red, the PBM, the middleman?
Yeah.
What that is, it's called a pharmacy benefits manager. Now, if this isn't squirrely, I don't know what is.
David Dayan writes about this, and it's...
This pharmacy benefits manager happens to be CVS Caremark. My pharmacy is Walgreens Specialty Prime. Okay, what a pharmacy benefits manager is they're getting paid from everybody to not fill your drugs. Okay, the insurance company pays the pharmacy benefit manager to manage the drug costs. So they get this upfront lump of money. And they tell the pharmacy benefit manager, make our drug costs as small as you can. Okay, so the drug manufacturers have to beg and plead with this middleman that is the one that's saying, Gina, you're Federal Blue Cross Blue Shield of Michigan. These are the only drugs we're going to cover for it. If you want something outside of that, you're going to have to pay a lot more because they're not on our list. So that middleman sucks out money from the insurance company. They're also sucking money from the drug manufacturer or wholesaler because they're holding them hostage. We're not going to put your drug on the list of stuff that's going to be covered by the insurance company unless you give us a kickback. Okay. Now, that PBM also talks to the pharmacies. And what they tell the pharmacies are, is we want you to cut down your dispensing fees and we want you to take as little as possible for the cost of the drug when you're filling those prescriptions. So that PBM, that middleman, is getting money from everybody. One, from the drug manufacturer or wholesaler, because they need to be on the list that the insurance company is going to pay for the drug. The insurance company is paying them to make their costs as small as possible. The pharmacy has to negotiate and say, okay, yeah, we'll only accept this pittance of a dispensing fee, because otherwise you're going to tell everybody to go to a different pharmacy. And you know who loses? The doctor and you. The doctor doesn't have any time to actually treat patients' diseases anymore. And you're supposed to have reduced premiums on your insurances instead of all the kickbacks that are just going to that pharmacy benefits manager. I don't know about you, but my premiums haven't gone down anytime recently. So the only person that's the organization that's sucking all the money out of the whole system is this middleman, but they're doing it for the benefit of the insurance company. They're making the manufacturers held hostage for what drugs they're going to include on their formulary, and they're squeezing the pharmacies as well. That's how this system works.
The pharmacy benefits manager, David Dayan over at the American Prospect, has written about this, and I try to understand it, and you did a great job. You should come back and explain this. We should know what a pharmacy benefit manager is. David did a pretty good job, but I have trouble understanding it because of the why. Like, why would somebody...
Costs. It's they're getting profits by reducing the costs to the insurance companies. That's where they're getting their profits from. They get a kickback, basically. And it's all at the expense of the patient and the doctors. I'm telling you, I felt so sorry for how many times I had to call. I called the doctor's office every single day after a while because I didn't have the medication, and they're insisting they filed all the paperwork and they don't know where to go with this. I'm out of the drug. They're watching me deteriorate and they don't know how to get the medication.